We know QuickBooks Online can be used for landlords, but did you know that real estate property management companies can also use QuickBooks Online? This video will show you how to use QuickBooks Online if you are the property management company. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What do property management companies do? Well, first, they collect rent on behalf of the building owners. Remember, the landlords are our customers, not the tenants that we collect the rent from. We then pay expenses that relate to the running of the property from the collected rent. They keep some of the collected rent as a service fee earned by us, the property management company. And then they pay the remainder to each landlord at the end of each month. They are also required to give a statement to each landlord client that explains the payment or the payout to the landlord client. The QuickBooks Online account that I am about to show you is already set up for a property management company. This video assumes you know the very basics of QuickBooks Online, and if you do not, don't worry. You can click the link in the description and teach yourself the very basics of QuickBooks Online right here from this same website. Now, you would have to set up customers or jobs if you set up a QuickBooks Online company. But in the case of a property management company, the landlord clients are customers and their tenants are set up as jobs. When you set up your chart of accounts, the chart of accounts in this file or in this QuickBooks Online account already has the accounts we need. Most of them are normal, typical accounts, but one special account to give attention to is the account called Payable to Landlord Clients. And that needs to be an accounts receivable type of account. Let's take a look. So, when we come here and we click Sales, Customers, you can see that Meadow Lane would be the name of the landlord, and Alan Arby and Betty Boop would be tenants who live in the landlord's property. They're the ones we collect the rent from, and we remit that rent. Net of our service fee, we remit that rent to the owner of Meadow Lane. Same thing with Peyton Place. You can see that Peyton Place is the landlord client whom we serve, and Dave Deeney and Gary Greenstein are tenants who live in Peyton Place. So we collect the rent from them and hand it over to the owner of Peyton Place. Now, let's look at the chart of accounts. Accounting chart of accounts. Looks like anything else, except the most important account is this one, payable to landlord clients, and it's an accounts receivable type of account. In fact, you're only really allowed to have one account receivable type of account, or at least one that will work. So if you want, you can make the other one inactive and use the one that you made. It's an accounts receivable type of account because it matches each individual landlord client's balance. But the name of it is showing you that it represents the money that you will pay to the landlords. So, it also has customized reports that are saved because we have to give our landlords reports at the end of the month along with the net amount of money that we have to pay out to them. And the two reports that make up the statement that we will give the landlord each month are a report called Payouts to Landlords, which is really a modified version of the customer balance detail, and Property Owner Remittance Withholdings, which is really a modified version of the profit and loss by customer. So let's take a look at that before we take a look at the account settings. So let's take a quick look. If you click reports, if I click reports, these are the four reports that I memorized. If I click payouts to landlords, you see that, you know, I changed the name, but it's really the customer balance detail. Reports, custom, property owner remittance report. Well, it doesn't really have any data, but it really was the profit and loss by customer. And then, of course, the trial balance and the general profit and loss are also helpful reports for you to access at any given moment. Now, the account settings must have track expenses by customers and make expenses billable, and both of those features have to be active if you are a property management company. So if I click the cogwheel and I go to account settings and I go to the category of expenses, you can see track expenses by items or customers turned on, and make expenses and items billable also switched on, so that you can see that everything is set up and we are now ready to perform our tasks as a property management company. You must follow these specific procedures as you operate your property management company in order to record your financial records correctly in QuickBooks Online. First, you must record management fees earned immediately upon collecting the rent from the tenants. Secondly, you have to make sure each check that you pay for the property identifies the tenant it relates to. So if you had a tenant that broke a window and you needed to make sure that repair expense was related to that tenant, you have to make sure that you not only include whom you're paying in the check, but include which tenant that caused or made the reason for the check in the first place, which you will see in a moment. You have to make sure that you run the withholdings report before billing the tenants for their expenses. And then you make an invoice for each deductible expense. You will make a separate invoice for each expense that a tenant cost one of your landlord clients that caused you to withhold more from your landlord client payout. Unfortunately, you must write one check to your landlord client for each tenant they have each month, because that check or that payout will match the statement that shows why they're getting that net amount after deducting your service fee as well as the tenant expenses. And now we will enter some example transactions, and you should note carefully how we make extensive use of the description field. Now, before we record any transactions, you should click reports, trial balance, and you'll see that right now this QuickBooks Online account has nothing. It's blank and all the numbers are starting from zero. And that should make the examples easier to understand. Let's imagine on May 1 we received $20,000 from Alan. And our percent fee for the service of performing management is 10%. So, how do we record this? Well, anytime you collect rent from a tenant on behalf of one of your landlord clients, you will click New and go to Bank Deposit. Now, you have to make sure that the correct bank account that the tenant's money was deposited into is showing in the top left, because you could have more than one bank type of account in the company. And of course, you're going to record the date that the money was put into our company bank account, from the tenant. Now, we click Received From and we choose the specific tenant. Alan Arby is a tenant under our client, and our client is the owner of Meadow Lane. So we click Alan Arby under Meadow Lane, and the account that we choose is the receivables account, which is the account that represents what we have to pay out to the client, payable to landlord clients. Now, the description is rent net of, so it's rent collected net of service fee. And maybe they gave us cash and we wrote them a handwritten receipt number one or whatever it is. Or maybe they gave us a check and then you would put the check number. However, notice the description says net of service fee. So if we collected $20,000 and we keep 10% for our service fee, that means the net amount that is payable to the client would equal $18,000. So you might have to have a calculator handy or Excel handy to record the net amount that is payable to the client. Because if the client, if the tenant gave us $20,000, we're only going to give to the client $18,000. And the other $2,000, guess what? The other $2,000, even though we choose the same customer when it says received from, the other $2,000 is the income that we enjoy for managing the property. And the name of that income account should be management fees income. So the total that went into the bank account was $20,000. $18,000 is payable back to the landlord client, and $2,000 is what we keep forever as our management fee income. And then when we click Save and Close, we can take a look at the trial balance, and you can see the total in our bank account is now $20,000. $18,000 is payable back to the landlord client, and $2,000 we keep forever as our profit. Now let's take a look at the next example. Let's imagine also on May 1, we received $15,000 from Betty. And again, our management fee in this example is 10%. Well, we're going to do the same thing in the same window, new bank deposit, because it is assumed she deposited directly into our account, and we received from Betty under Meadow Lane, and the amount that is payable back to the landlord is the $15,000, but 10% less. And I happen to know that 10% of $15,000 is $1,500. So if we take out the $1,500 from the $15,000, that means the amount of the $15,000 that's payable back to the landlord is $13,500. And a simple elementary school math calculator will help you. And this would be rent collected for May net of service fee. Because it's net of the service fee. The service fee of the $1,500 gets recorded under the same client, or the same tenant actually, but it's actually our income and goes into an income account called management fees income. Then we click Save and Close, and you can see the total in the bank is now $35,000. Where $31,500 has to be payable back to the clients, and we've earned as our income $3,500. You can check the other reports to see what they look like. Right now, payouts to landlords looks like we owe Meadow Lane $18,000 just for Alan, and we owe the owner of Meadow Lane $13,500 just for Betty. But that's before we apply any expenses that they cost us. Now let's imagine on May 5th we needed to pay Calvin Cleaners for a spill in Alan's apartment. And Alan is responsible for paying that, or actually the Meadow Lane owner, who Alan is a tenant of, is responsible for paying that. So we're going to take that out of the money that we collected from Alan. Now, the way to do that, watch. You click New, Check or Expense. If we paid online, we could use expense. If we handed them a check, we could pay by check. But there's really no difference between these windows. There's no difference in the result. So let's just click expense. And we'll say that the date is May 5th. And we'll say that we paid Calvin Cleaners. And the reason we paid Calvin Cleaners was cleaning expense. And the amount we paid was $250. Now, we must mark it as billable because we must know which particular tenant under which particular customer caused that expense and is responsible, and therefore we will deduct accordingly. Mark it as billable. You should put both in the description and the memo field, you should put that Alan, was it Alan who made the spill? Yes, Alan responsible for spill, or whatever you want to put. You have plenty of room in this description field, and I suggest that you copy whatever's in the description field into the memo field, and that will help you later when you bill the tenant and lower the payout. So click Save and Close, and now we'll be ready for the next one. What about May 6th? We paid Rex Repair Shop $300 for a door in Betty's apartment. And let's imagine it was Betty's fault that it was broken. So we therefore will deduct it from the payout regarding the rent that we have to give over to Meadow Lane, the Meadow Lane apartment building owner, for the tenant named Betty. And we do the same thing. We click New, Expense. We change it to May 6th, the day that we paid. And we paid Rex Repair Shop. And the reason, you know, normally you would put we paid with check, whatever check number we put, whatever. But the reason we're paying is we're paying repair expense. Repair expense. Okay, very good. And it, with the amount we paid was $300, and it is billable, meaning we're going to deduct it from the payout of Betty's collected rent. Now, in the description field, you can put Betty broke door or whatever you want, and I suggest that you copy it and you paste it into the memo field because that will help you later. Click Save and Close. Now let's imagine on May 15th, we paid Lana the lawyer $400 in legal services regarding Alan the tenant. So it's the same thing. Expense. We paid Lana the lawyer. We paid her on May 15th. And the reason we paid was legal and professional fees, somewhere in the expense section here. Or we could, it filters it, so you can type in LE and push tab. And then, of course, we can put, how much is that now? $400. And again, mark it as billable. It relates to Alan Arby, and we can put, argument over the spill. Spill related. or whatever you need to put, but remember, you should also copy it into the memo field. You'll see why later. Okay, now we click save and close, and let's do the last one. Let's imagine on May 16th, we had to pay Lana the lawyer $500 over the argument that Betty broke the door. So this is the last one, expense, May 16th, Lana the lawyer. No, we don't want to repeat necessarily what was in the past transaction. This is legal and professional fees, and this time it was Betty argue. You could basically put whatever reminds you of the situation or makes it clear, and of course you have to put it billable to the specific tenant under Meadow Lane, in this case Betty. Don't forget to copy from the description to the memo field, and then click save and close. You should be aware that there are two places that you can see all expenses that you record that you marked as billable, and those two places are the unbilled charges report as well as the property owner remittance report, which is really the profit and loss by customer, just, you know, customized for our needs. So let's take a look at those reports. If we click reports and we go to the custom report, unbilled charges, all four of the expenses that we just recorded are still here because we have not assigned them to the tenants or the clients yet. We will do that during the end of month procedures, and then they will disappear from the unbilled report and go on the client's report because we will be deducting them from the rent payout. You should also know that the payout, the property owner remittance report, really it's originally the, you know, I changed the name, it's the profit and loss by customer, but it shows you everything. In other words, let's say for Alan, it shows you this is how much management fees we kept, and this is how much of each of the other individual expenses we kept. And then the rest would be the payout that would show on the other report. Same thing with Betty. This is the management fee that we withheld from the payout. And then this is the, these are the expenses that we withhold from the payout. So this report, client by client or tenant by tenant, shows what we withheld or what we will withhold from the payout to the landlord at the end of the month. And of course, if you looked at the general report, the trial balance, no matter what, the trial balance is going to show, you know, the reduction in the bank account for each expense that we paid, and it's going to show the overall total expenses that our company has. But these will disappear once we assign them to the client. Once we withhold them from the client, then our company no longer has these expenses, because if we withhold them from the payout, it means the landlord client really paid them, and they will disappear from the trial balance as well once they're billed during the end of month procedures. So after doing the end of month procedures, all billable expenses will disappear from both reports. And that's why you must follow the end of the month procedures very carefully. At the end of the month, first we will run the withholdings report for each tenant, and you will need to export that to Excel and filter it one by one. After exporting, saving, or printing the withholdings report, then we'll make an invoice for each of the expenses that we marked as billable, and we have to make sure the invoice for each billable expense has the date that we actually paid The billable or reimbursable expense. So what do I mean? Well, first, as I said, if you click reports and go to the property owner remittance, this column here is what you must give Alan at the end of the, or excuse me, you must give to Meadow Lane, the owner of Meadow Lane, as a result of tenant Alan, to show this is how much we kept from Alan's rent for our management fees, and this is how much we kept from Alan's rent for the expenses that Alan caused the landlord. So you could, and the problem with QuickBooks Online is you cannot filter it customer by customer or tenant by tenant. You would have to export the entire report to Excel and then set up an Excel macro to isolate each customer, and this column would be one of two reports that you would give to the owner of Meadow Lane at the end of the month regarding that particular tenant and the money that they're going to get from that tenant. Now, when we finish with the payouts to landlords report, and then of course it will show you how much, when we finish, we then open the payouts to landlords report and show them how much to pay. See, right now, we cannot do that because we didn't make an invoice yet at the end of each month. Let me show you what I mean. Let's go back a little. So the end of the month procedure is, first we run the withholdings report. We run the withholdings report and print it client by client or export it to Excel. Then only after dealing with this report, now we are going to make an invoice for each of the billable expenses. And we have to make the invoices after we export that other report, or they're going to disappear from that report. So the procedures have to be done this way. Watch this. We're going to click New. Well, before we do that, let's look at the other report. Report and payouts to landlords. Now, before we tag on the billable expenses, it looks like the total amount of rent that we collected, net of our fee, is what we're going to pay. But these are not the right numbers yet. We have to include each of the billable expenses. So let's do that for Alan. New invoice. And we're going to choose Alan Arby. Now, look what happened when we chose Alan Arby. In the right panel, QuickBooks is telling us we have a billable expense from May 5th and a billable expense on May 15th, and you have to do them one by one. I'm going to add just the billable expense so that the description comes over, and I'm going to put this as May 5th because that was the date that we paid the billable expense. And when I click Save and Close, look at the report. Notice the amount of the payout to the Meadow Lane owner decreased by the amount of the expense that the tenant cost us. So let's do the other one. New invoice. Choose that tenant for that landlord client. And again, any billable expenses that lower the payout will show up in the right panel. Click Add and notice the description comes over exactly as we need. And that was May 16th. So you're going to put the date of that particular expense as the date of the invoice that you add. And when you click Save and Close, now look what happened with Alan. We collected his rent at the beginning of the month, net of our fee. Then on the 5th, we had to pay $250 because of this guy. On the 16th, we had to pay $400 because of Alan. And as a result, we're only going to give back to the Meadow Lane landlord $17,350 because that's what they deserve after we take our fee and after we put our expenses. And we're going to print this to show the owner of Meadow Lane how each expense was deducted to derive the amount of the payout. Let's do Betty, new invoice. And when we choose Betty Boop under the Meadow Lane owner, we see all of the billable expenses that we recorded during the month. Let's add the May 6th one and notice the description comes right over. And we have to make sure that the date of the invoice is the date that we paid the expense. Now when we click Save and Close, you can see that the payout to the Meadow Lane owner regarding Betty has been decreased by an expense that Betty was responsible for. Let's do the very last one, invoice, Betty Boop, and you'll see there's one left, May 16th, add, and you can see the description comes right over. And then you can see that we did this on May 50, whatever it was, you put that date. Now, when we click Save and Close, you can see that we collected $13,500 in rent, which is net of our fee, minus each of the expenses that Betty is responsible for. So therefore, the amount of the final payout to the landlord of Meadow Lane, the owner, for Betty, the final payout, will be $12,700. Now, before we actually pay the landlord, let's take a look at the trial balance. What do you think the total money that we owe to all or for all tenants are? Well, it would be the total at the bottom here. So if you click reports and you go to the trial balance, you can see payable to landlord clients, right now we owe them $30,050, which matches the total from the other report that shows us how much to pay out to the client. Report, payouts to landlords. They're our client. $17,350 goes to Meadow Lane just for Alan. So we now have to look at the payouts for landlord report to see how much to pay. And you record the payment in the checks window or the expense window, depending on how you pay. And it will be one recorded payout per tenant or one check per tenant. So just for Alan, we're going to pay the owner of Meadow Lane $17,350. New check. It's for Alan Arby under Meadow Lane. It's for the end of May. That's when we're paying. And the amount we're paying is $17,350. Because that's how much we owe the owner of Meadow Lane, specifically for Alan. Now, this one you will not put billable. Do not put billable. But you do have to put the payouts to landlord clients, the account that represents what we owe to clients. And then, of course, you have to put the correct tenant both up here and over here. Now look what happens when we click Save and Close. It shows that we now that we paid them, we now owe zero for the Meadow Lane tenant to the owner of, we owe zero for tenant Allen. We now owe to the Meadow Lane because we now paid them their $1,350, and this report shows everything. Same thing with Betty. New check, Betty is $12,700. It's still the end of the month, so we put Betty's name both here. Then, of course, we find the account payable to landlords, $12,700. And, of course, we put the same client. Now, when we click Save and Close, we now paid for tenant Betty to landlord of Meadow Lane, and now we owe zero as a result of Betty. And when we look on our trial balance, we see we owe nothing because we paid our monthly payouts to landlord.